The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people prefer darkness to light, because their works are evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come toward the light, so that his works might be not exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, today's homily isn't going to make any sense. That's because the readings today don't make any sense. If you've ever been watching some sports event on TV, like a baseball game or a stock car race, you may have seen someone holding up a great big sign that says John 3:16 on it. How many people here have ever seen that big sign, John 3:16? Lots of you. Absolutely. They do that because they want you to look up what John 3:16 is in the Bible. Reminds me of when I wanted to make a big sign saying John 11:35 on it, when the Calgary Flames won the Stanley Cup. You know what John 11:35 is? Jesus wept. Of course, I didn't. Figured Jesus probably wouldn't find it as funny as I did. Anyway, John 3:16. They want us to look it up because it's a perfect summary of everything we believe as Christians. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that whoever believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. That's beautiful, eh? Sure sounds nice. And that's it. Sums up our whole faith. Only problem is, when you think about it, it really doesn't make any sense. I'll tell you something else that doesn't make any sense. My dog. My dog makes no sense at all, because he loves me, and I can't figure out why. Some people say dogs aren't capable of love. Most of those folks are people who don't have dogs. My dog Nemo, he loves me. He might be too dumb to know what love is, but he loves me. I can tell he loves me because he's always following me around from one room to the next Or he sits at the bathroom door and waits for me, you know, to come out. And he's always cuddling with me, no matter how uncomfortable he is, you know. He'll rest his face right on top of my face and plan to go to sleep right there, you know. So I have to move him out of the way. But he doesn't care. He loves me so much. It doesn't matter how bad I smell. In fact, the worse I stink, the more odious the odor is wafting off of me, the more he jumps all over me and just wants to stick his nose everywhere in my armpits and every other part of me that might be making some smell. You can use your imagination to figure out that. He loves it. He loves me. And I know he loves me because when I leave him in the church office to go come to Mass here, he'll sit in the front room and he'll just whine and pout and moan and just go, drives the ladies in the office crazy. And then when I finally walk back in, he's like, he jumps up on me, his little tail is wagging, like his whole back half is wagging back and forth, like a little hula dancer, you know, just going crazy. And he jumps on me, and he's slurping me across the face with his tongue, which is dangerous, because I don't know what he's been doing with that tongue before I got in there. And he isn't, and even if he hasn't eaten, and I have treats for him, first he has to greet me, and then he'll go for the treats. And I can tell that he loves me Just from the way he looks at me, you know? Just from those little brown eyes. Looking up at me, looking right into my soul. Maybe sitting there with a chew toy hanging out of his mouth. Aww. Hoping that I'll come and play with him. Or when he wakes me up first thing in the morning by sticking his cold, wet nose right directly into my belly button, which fits absolutely perfectly. Make me squeal like a girl. Ah! And which makes him go, "Roo!" Or the way he cocks his head back and forth like this while I'm singing in the shower, trying to figure out what that screeching noise is coming from there, you know? And the crazy thing is, because he loves me, I find I love him too. In fact, that's the thing about us dog owners. We're all insane. Every one of us. Only a dog owner can go from his normal voice, like I'm talking right now, to, "Hello, puppy! How's my puppy? You're so cute! Oh, you're such a cute little puppy! How long as you are!" Stark raving lunatics. Every one of us. And the dog loves it too. He's like, oh yeah. Keep talking like an idiot. I love it. Sometimes all I have to do is think of Nemo. I'll be sitting in the car driving back from Safeway and I automatically just start talking like that. "Hello, Nemo, aren't you so nice?" He's not even there in the car and I'm talking this way. "Oh, Nemo, you're such a good puppy dog." So there you go. Father Mike is nuts. But it feels good. Try it sometime. In fact, for your penance this month, when you go to confession, I'm going to make you talk like that all day to everyone you run into. "Hello, so nice to see you. You're such a good boy. I love you so much, too." So there you go. My dog Nemo definitely loves me. Only I can't figure out why. It's not because I play with him all the time, because I don't. I'm pretty sure it's not because I feed him, because the stuff I feed him doesn't taste very good. Don't ask me how I know that, okay? Just trust me that it doesn't taste very good. It's not because I'm always there for him, because I'm not. Sometimes I leave him at home 6, 7, 8 hours at a time. It's not because I am so smart, or so holy, or so funny, or because he likes my homilies. I figure that's why a lot of people like me, because they like my preaching. But Nemo doesn't care at all about my preaching. When I practice my sermons on him, he just falls asleep. Not unlike some members of our congregation here today. No, Nemo seems to love me for no reason at all. He just loves me. And you know, I think that's good for me. It's good for me to have someone give me love that I don't have to earn. In fact, I can't earn it. Personally, I think everyone needs to have someone or something that loves us for absolutely no reason at all. They just love us. Whether it's a friend or a family member or your child, that is until they turn 13 and decide that they hate you. We all need someone who just loves us, period. I think it's good for our health. The reason I think it's so important is because it teaches us to believe something else that makes absolutely no sense at all. That God loves us. I don't know why. Sometimes I'll ask a classroom full of kids, "Why does God love us?" And they answer, "Because he made us." So then I'll ask them, "Okay, so why did God make us?" "Because he loves us." And it doesn't make sense that God, the creator of the universe and all it contains, with all its wonders, who holds all time and space and matter and energy within himself, who is beyond all human comprehension, compared to whom we are as insignificant as dirt, all of us, even the John Paul IIs and his Mother Teresa's, compared to God, dirt, that God would love us. Much less that God would give his life for us. That's ludicrous. Speaking of my dog Nemo, whom I do love, obviously, I've asked myself from time to time, would I give my life to save my dog? I mean, I love the little guy, But do I love him that much? Would I stand in front of a bus to save Nemo? That doesn't make any sense, does it? He's a dog. Well, it makes even less sense that God would die for us. The difference between us and God is much greater than between me and my dog. The idea of God dying for us, dirt, doesn't make any sense at all. But he does. Jesus is the proof. The cross and resurrection are the proof. Today's Eucharist is the proof. This is a gift that we cannot earn. We can't be holy enough to receive. All that we can do is say thank you and accept it. And try to live lives that show that we're thankful. Live lives that show that we believe that God loves us for no reason at all. Other than that, God is love. Amen.
Come, come, come. Hop.
Ready? We're going to sing now, you and me. Ready?
Come on, sing with me.